Now, it's a messy history that I've described so far, but let's just take a side route here. As I mentioned earlier on, the book of the Maccabees didn't make it into the Jewish tradition. Obviously, Jews were aware of the general scope of things. They had the description of the events in the Talmud, which was studied, of course. They had some access to Josephus, but they hardly ever looked at the book of the Maccabees. So they didn't have much more than a hazy idea of a lot of these things when we move through the Middle Ages. Christians, however, as I showed you with some medieval imprints, were fascinated with it. And especially when you get to the era of the breakup of the church and the Reformation, the Counter-Reformation, there is renewed Christian interest in Judah Maccabee because for Christians, he represents, correctly, I think, a symbol of fighting for religious freedom. And Protestants and Catholics both see this as an opportunity to strike out their statement on the value of freedom of worship. And you see in the 17th century already several poems and plays appearing that celebrate Yehudah Maccabee in particular. You see none other than Handel himself even composing music, an opera to go with Yehudah Maccabee's story. You see Henry Wadsworth Longfellow in English composing a five-act verse tragedy dedicated to it. That's absolutely fascinating because he is seen as a figure responding to religious freedom. He is also seen in the 20th century by both Christians and Jews as a figure of national revival. As the idea of self-determination becomes much more popular among the stateless peoples of the world, then many begin to see him as someone standing up for the rights of national determination of the Jews and, of course, of other peoples as well. Here, have a look at this example. This is by a Swiss writer, Karl Boxer, and the title of this book is interesting, Judas Maccabeus, of course, our hero. Ein Kleinvolk kämpft Glaube und Heimat. A small people, this is the subtitle, a small people fights for faith and homeland. Which I think is a pretty good précis of what Yehudah Maccabee stood for, but we can see, written in 1943 under Nazi occupation, what this means to the oppressed peoples of Europe. Fascinating, I think.